think we already discussed what is an idea, what is a business idea, and what is a business model. Today, I will give you more about the business plan, and at the end of the session, give your small business plans or ideas. Okay. So what I do is I will share the PPT with you all and go with the discussions. And in the meantime, you can stop me or ask me anything.
Sir, the image is not visible.
Sir, your screen is not shared, sir.
So am I visible to you on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, so PPT is visible to you all?
No, sir.
Oh,
no, sir.
I'm absolutely sorry. I thought it was shared. Just a moment. I thought you can't see the image. I'm sorry. Can you see now, friends?
Yes,
can you all
now.
See the
yes,
PPT with image?
Yes, sir.
That's yes, good. Sir.
Thank you. Now, can any one of you explain me this?
Yes, sir.
Tanuja, can you tell me?
Yes. Sir, without nothing, sir, that question mark is, we don't have any idea till now.
Okay.
That bulb symbol represents, we have an idea, we got an idea.
Okay.
Then we will implement that idea, sir. If it works, we will earn money, we will get profits and all. If else, again, we will think of another idea to get it work.
Good. Very good. Anyone else? Surajan?
If we have any doubt regarding anything, we'll start researching about it, sir. So, by researching, we'll get to know many points and that develops into an idea, sir. And by working on that idea, we can make profits or else that idea remains as idea itself, sir.
Fantastic. Thank you. Thanks, Rujana and Tanuja. So these two students have prepared the session. What exactly the starting point of a B plan should be. So the question mark is all about, if you don't have a question, there is no business at all. Forget about an idea, nothing is happening. Even why business, even in this session, if you don't have a question mark, if you don't have a question, there is no learning at all, as simple as that. Okay, so for everything, question mark is the starting point. That's what the image says. So if you want to do a business, small business or big business, okay, you need to have a question mark. What that product is, what that service is, what these people need, what are the gaps in my village, what are the problems in my street, what are the problems in this country, what Indians want, what working professionals want, how are working professionals managing in lockdown? There are many questions. So all these questions can be converted into an idea. Okay. It's an idea. So if that idea works, that becomes a business idea and you start making money. If that idea doesn't work, again, you have to go back. The question remains the same, but your ideation gets extended. The process of ideation gets extended and you will keep on doing that. You will be in that loop till you convert that into monetary value. That is the starting point of a business. If you don't have money in your mind, there I showed dollar, you should have rupee. You're doing business in India. So how to make rupees, you should know. Then only it will be a starting point. Okay. Then today I framed 7 important areas to discuss. And this is highly practical. There are no concepts here. Okay. So what is a business plan? Why a person needs a business plan? How to write a business plan? And how the business plan is composed? And to whom you are writing? To whom you have to send the business plan? And once the whole thing is done, how to execute the business plan. Okay. So are you guys ready to take this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All of you, Sunil, Geeta, Monica, Sai Priya.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let's go one by one. Can anyone explain? Bharati? Can anyone else? Mallika?
Sir, business plan is nothing but a formal set of, I mean, statements what you are going to implement in a business, or the idea how to implement and how they are going to implement, in what ways they are implement, or the alternatives, whether if they fail or if there are any alternatives, the second options, etc., come into a business plan, sir.
Good. Very good. Thank you very much, Monica.
Thank you.
When someone is asking you to give a business plan, you know, you should know how exactly prima facie, what exactly business plan talks about. So it is a summarized set of business model. It talks about your business model. I think I had been telling you the question mark, idea, business model. Okay. The whole thing as a business model is presented to someone. Okay. So it comprises of different stakeholders, objectives, operations, and with a structured plan matching with the goals or objectives stated by the person. Okay. As simple as that. So there is no standard statement summary or structure for all the plans. It differs from person to person, size to size, nature of the product, and so on, and to whom it will be given. So this is how, in a simple way, business plan looks like. It should be very clear. It cannot be generalized. It cannot be in air. You mean it, it's on the paper. Okay. So it is one page or one, 2 pages or 100 pages. It cannot have 100 pages, but it is very clear. You cannot go beyond that. That is a business plan. You're talking about your business model, how to make money. You're attracting others. You're trying to convince others. Then why even today I ask you to write a business plan, come with a business model, your own business idea, whatever. So why a business plan is required? Okay. Just quickly go through them. I gave you 7 points. Be ready to respond. I may call anyone. Sunil?
Yes, sir.
Go on.
A business plan is required to make a decisions perfectly, sir. And also identify the...
Okay. Anyone else? Rajshekar, can you try?
Not now, sir.
Sorry? Rajshekar.
Sir, not now, sir.
What do you mean, not now? Switch on your video first.
Sir. Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Not now, sir.
No, what do you mean not now?
Sir, no. Actually,
wait for more minutes or next day? I mean, Pavan is here. No.
No, okay. Sir. Sir, shall I?
Yeah, please go ahead.
So the first point here is saying about turning opportunity, means opportunity should be turned as a money making machine. The opportunity, okay, that we have should be, we should turn our opportunity into money making machine. Like, for example, we have some idea and that should be turned into, you know, money making machine means we have to get profits out of the opportunity that we have, and it also helps us to identify the future needs. For example, now, before pandemic, sanitizers and masks were like not so essential, or they were like luxurious goods before pandemic, but now it is necessity. So the manufacturers or any the manufacturers is thinking about the business man sanitizers and mask is one of the you know booming business right now. So they have turned the opportunity into their business, and also it will help us to take appropriate decisions. So business plan is that's why necessary.
Good. Thank you very much, Meghna.
So yes, sir.
Sunil and Rajshekar let me down and you let me up. Thank you very much. Again, I'm telling you, keep your videos on. Even Meghna, keep your video on. Okay. So let me explain. Let me help you. See, why business plan is required. Let us quickly go through one by one. First thing is, unless and until you write a business plan, you don't understand how your business model is an opportunity as a money making machine or not. I think Meghna was saying, sir, I want to help the handicraft people in Odisha tribal areas. I was clearly asking her, how do you make money out of it? If you remember, Meghna? Yeah? Because
yes, sir.
You have to write
yes,
the business
sir, I remember.
Plan. Until and unless you write it, you yourself will not understand whether you can do business out of it, out of this idea. That is number one. Number two is, consider all the facets of business. You know, many students come to me, sir, I have a brilliant idea, I will do this, I will do that. They fly high, you know. They are very much energetic, you know, they are just flying from even engineering students, management students, they come to me. Then I puncture their ideas, their energies, I'm sorry, and they come on to the ground level. Okay. Why? Because they don't really see the facets of the business. They just ignore. They feel so good about the idea. And that stage got over. Question mark, idea, business model. Okay. So now we have to understand the facets of the business. What do you mean by these facets of business? Your stakeholders, rules, regulations, investments to start with. You have to, your society, your own family members, will they allow or not? These are the things. Okay. Then third one is to identify future needs. Why future? You want to start, you want to do business right now. Why you are worried about future? The reason here is a product which is so good today. Say for example, Meghna was talking about pandemic, sanitizers. Maybe sanitizers, masks, even many countries like Canada or even USA, I think the healthcare professionals are close to the salaries of the doctors, some of the doctors. That is happening now. In future, it may not be. The mask as a product, sanitizer as a product, or anything as a product related to the COVID-19 or lockdown or this pandemic. It could happen now, but you should think about future also. Some other project which is so good now, electrical product, it is not good now. Electric vehicles, it is not good now. It may be a good click in future. A diesel vehicle, it is hot. Highly demanded, price is high for a diesel vehicle compared to petrol vehicle. It is happening now. How about future? Okay. So solar power, these are the areas you have to look into. Future. Present connected to future. The next one, testing the viability and feasibility. I think there is a movie, people, they know how to make beer at home and they do door delivery also and they make huge money out of it. But they have to understand it is not permitted to make beer at their own place and sell. A lot of departments, a lot of regulatory policies, rules, regulations are hindering you, stopping you. They may put you behind the bars also. So the viability and feasibility of a product is more important. Some business ideas are so good, but they demand to infuse loads of money, which is tough. Say for example, if one of you want to start a business which requires 10 crores, okay, I think that will be very tough to start with. For small business, it is okay. Then partners and management team Again, it's a problem to decide. You have to be very clear. Yeah, I know my people, I have my own people, but you have to put it on paper. Who are your partners? Who is accompanying you? Who are your supporters? Who will be in your team? Who will be managing? Are you employing? Are your own owners, co-founders will be there with your management team? You have to very clearly write on the paper and designate them. Then only it will be clear. Then identifying the size and source of finance. So people say, I can get money, I will do, I will get angel investors, you know, I will do crowdsourcing, you know, there are many ideas out there. But practically in your place, in your vicinity, in your network, is it possible? You have to check that. Then confidence for decision making. When everything is there on a single paper, okay, see, if I don't know the list of students in my class, I will be lost. I can't take the names. But if I have a list of students with me on my table, I'll be confident to connect with all the students. Okay. So this is why you need a business plan if you want to start small business. Without a business plan, it's difficult to think deep into it. Now, sir, you said that write a business plan, gave a homework, but how to write it? That's the reason many of you couldn't respond. I can understand that. So to help you that, this is what I have given. Okay. So who should write the plan? What should be the plan cover? How many pages? Should I mention all the confidential data? How it should be presented? These are the five areas when you talk about how to write it. Who should write it? Anyone? Yatish? Yatish is absent today? Shravya.
Yes, sir. So the one who has the idea to start the business.
So today, now we are supposed to give you the B plan about your business model. It is Shravya who has to write the business plan. Don't expect the professor to write. Don't expect the class representative to write. Don't expect your classmates to help you. Okay. As Shravya is rightly saying, it is you. Okay. So why I put this question is, you may tell me, this is not a hint to you. In your assignment, it is you, you should write it. But in addition to that, there could be, you're a professional management student. Okay, fine. You can write your business plan and you're having a course also related to it. But how about a student who is there in 10th grade, want to start a business? A student is there in 10 plus 2, want to start business. A student is there in BCom, BBA, BTech, but not into MBA with a course like this. They don't know how to write a business plan. Okay, how do they write? So they have to outsource. They have to reach people like chartered accountants, like lawyers, like doctors, who are the professional consultants you have. You also have startup consultants or business consultants who are there to give their business services, including writing a business plan for you. So probably there are two objectives, two ways of writing a business plan. One is for yourself or others who are professional. Then what should the business plan cover? I think when I ask you what is a business plan, the whole scope was given there. You should talk with why you want to start this business plan with business objectives. And you should write about the whole business model, how you make money out of it. Okay. Then your operations, stakeholders, facets of the business, probable problems, okay, the strengths, highlighted areas for successful business, all things should have as a scope. The coverage of your business plan should be these things. Then how many pages to write? There is no standard rule. It should be 5 pages, 10 pages or 100 pages. It could be minimum of 1 page. You cannot write in half page. For sure, My students always ask me, sir, how many pages to submit an assignment? Okay. So like that, don't go with that kind of rules. You should cover all the scope which I told you in the second question. That is, it will be 1 page, 2 page, 3 page also. And should I mention all the confidential data? What do you say? Sai Priya, you have a very good idea. You have a business model and you are writing a business plan which has given to be others. Will you share the confidential data? Sai Priya, are you there?
No. No. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I will not share,
okay.
Sir.
Yes, Sai Priya is there. No. Confidential,
yes,
data.
Yes, I am there, sir. I will not share my confidential data, sir.
Okay. Why? Why? If you don't share the confidential data, who will give you funding? Who will invest your business? Okay, you may.
I will first test the investors, sir. Later, if I get the confidence on them, then I will definitely share my data.
Okay. Let me give you the example of Google founders, Larry Page and his co-founder. They were struggling. They had a very good code to get a new search engine. Okay. They approached Yahoo. That time Yahoo was only, I think, leading search engine at the time. And they clearly told that we already have a search website, Yahoo search. Why should we take you? Okay. They couldn't convince them. Then they started giving it to many people. They have to attract the investors to start their own venture. So for them, they have to talk about the code, but the real thing they never shared. Okay. But they managed how their coding is different from Yahoo search, how Google search will be different from Yahoo search. So some technicality, which is also confidential, they shared, but the real thing they didn't share. If they share it, it will be open. Okay, they can go with other business people also. So confidential data, as Sai Priya was rightly mentioning, you can never share the say, for example, vaccine for COVID. No, most of the pharma companies are working on that. Really, it cannot be shared at all. Okay, but how their vaccine will be effective to others, they have to, like, it is, it cannot, it need not be stored. The money to spend on storage is very less. You can quickly transfer to many countries. That's how you have to differentiate. But the equation you can never share. If you give the equation of the vaccine for COVID-19, I think you are lost. Everyone will start their own vaccine. So confidential data definitely cannot be given, but some outlook of the data of that product should be given to others in business plan. So how should it be presented? So presenting the business plan, first of all, one has to talk. I'm giving this B plan right now to you all. It is online. But if it is interesting, you may call me, sir. Can you elaborate on this business plan? I want to invest in this. Okay, because others are also watching us. Let us have a one-to-one interaction so that I will be convinced to invest in your business. So that depends. You can send a PPT, you can send the documents, have the interactions, you can make a video out of it. You can do multimedia effects in the video and send it, how money comes, how it will grow year on year, future and so on. Okay. So this is how you have to put your things in your mind when you write a business plan. Okay. Then the structure or business plan composition could be something like this. Have a quick reading of this, all of you. So have a good reading. Ask anyone respond. Okay, I will explain this. So the first one, purpose of the plan is, why are you writing this plan? Okay, so is it to attract the customers? Are you trying to reach big customers and start business before you start? Or are you giving this to a regulator? Are you writing this business plan to get the subsidies from the government schemes? So what is the purpose of the plan? Based on the purpose, I think the composition will change. It should be highly flexible. Then you should whatever to whom, whatever may be the purpose, business model should be perfect. Okay, so where it starts, where it ends, production, profits, input, sales, in the whole process it should be very clear. Okay, so business model should be very clear. So you guys should be working more on your business model. Then SWOT, I wish you all are aware of SWOT analysis. You have done some examples or some assignments or homeworks or case studies in your first semester itself, okay, on companies. So when you're launching your own business model, you should have very good SWOT analysis. See, when you say SWOT analysis, you cannot give the real threats. You cannot talk about real weak areas, okay? You should talk about threats and weak areas where you can work on. Okay. So for example, I cannot compete with the giant FMCG companies in India. So that is the biggest weakness. If you say that, you cannot talk about your own business. Don't do business. Okay. So talk about the weakness or threat area in such a way that you can manage with the help of big investment, with the help of attracting new clients or customers, with the help of employing big people, which are technically so strong, functionally so strong, CEOs of some other companies, you want to employ them, maybe like that. Then what kind of a management team you are planning? Please understand, in small business, this is the biggest problem. One person wants to do everything, okay? In small business, it may happen, there is an opportunity, there is a scope, but still you need to leverage on your team. Okay, let it be small team, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 10 or whatever. You should clearly cut the whole team into different groups and you should match them to functional areas. Okay, so these functional areas map to set of people, 1 or 2 or 3 or more or 5 or 10 or 100s, whatever. Then your job as a promoter or as a founder becomes easy to manage. Okay, so again, further, independent functional team should have very clear goals. Okay, the objectives of the business matching with functional objectives, that's very important. When this is done, there will be some projections from each function or each area, each vertical of the business, for short term, medium term, long term. Say for this year, for the next year, what is your plan? That's a projection. It could be sales forecasting, income forecasting, revenue forecasting, or sales numbers alone as a forecast. You can do that. Down the line, 2 to 3 years, what is your plan? Down the line, 5 to 10 years, what is your plan? Each and every department or functional area should work on that. Your business plan should consist this. Then funding. How do you do all these things? How do you get money? There are many business areas where advertisement itself is a major expense. Okay. So sometimes if you work on an aggregator model, I think spending money on websites, spending money on making an app, spending money on digital marketing, you know, these things are the major investments. How do you do it? Okay. If it is, this is an example, if it is something else, how do you do the funding and what kind of sources, what experience did you have to be successful in accumulating those funds? This is composition of a B plan, structure or composition of a B plan. I think functional areas I had given, quickly go through this image. I think marketing students should have a better idea of this, and even at the second sem marketing is given to you, so you should be talking, when you talk about selling your product, marketing is all about future, right? You should know these four facets. One is market research. It is very difficult to do market research by yourself. There are many market research companies selling the data, okay? You can get from them, regional wise, state wise, nationwide, pan India also you can get it. Then based on that, what is your target segment? Who are your target customers? What is your market segment? What is a niche market for your product? You have to understand all these things. Then you have, accordingly, you have to frame marketing objectives and strategies, and every quarter or every year you should continually get the feedback for the successful execution of the marketing plans. Then the finance function, so funding estimates or capital estimates are, I think there is a small error there, you can correct that. Funding, how much money, you know, you have to estimate first. Is it 10 lakhs, 1 crore, 10 crores? How much you need? It is not simply saying that, but you should be very clear on that. Once you are clear, find funding alternatives. It is by yourself. Invite partners, invite more owners, borrow from your friends, students, relatives, colleagues, producers, neighbors, anyone. Then once they are clear, mobilize funds, get on your desk, then utilize them, then have a good repayment discipline. If it is equity, distribute the returns or dividends properly. This is the broad areas in finance. Then when investors look at your business plan, I think this is what they look at. For them, initial dividend distribution, I think no one dares to do that. Okay, any startup you take, venture capital firms or PE firms, private equity firms, they don't look at dividends. Then what do they look at? It is the second one. Sale of the business or dilution of equity. What do? They start with small amount of money. They invest in a small business or a startup, and they escalate into big. They stress the promoter every day. They keep on calling, what's happening? What is that you're doing? And so on. They are plunged into the business completely. They keep on talking, and they will not stop till the business grows exponentially. 1 crore worth of business becomes, say, 10 crores or 50 crores or 100 crores. That is their objective. It's not that all startups will become like that. They work like that. Once they feel, then they come out of the business through IPOs and so on. They sell their equity and try to look for some other startup. That's what they do. Then business plan is more about attracting investors to get money, debt or equity. Even you have to write for your banks or NBFCs also. Corporate people, they do that. Just now I was talking about investors, let it be angel investor or venture capital or PE firms. Or sometimes you need to write business plan for government concerned departments. Say for example, in India we have MSMEs. Lot of schemes are there. Please go through them. They are very much useful to you or to get the subsidies, okay, and easy process, single window clearance kind of thing, they're available. So for these kind of people who are investors giving you money, you need to write the business. Then to whom to send the business plan? So it is getting very tough. It is very easy to show on the slide that these are the investors, we get the money, but hundreds of varieties of angel investors are there, varieties of hundreds of VCs are there, hundreds of PEs are there, hundreds of schemes are there. So to whom to send, it's a big problem. Okay, so first and foremost is, don't blindly send your business plans to each and every one, because just rayes sudham tagilte tagilindi ledante ledu. Don't think like that. Okay, you have to identify the match, right match. Okay, so by matching risk appetite, cost of funding and desire to control with the investor. Okay, your risk appetite and level to transfer, your cost of funding and level to borrow, your desire to control, level to dilute. So keeping these three minds, three in your minds, okay, you have to search for the VC firm or PE firm or government schemes or banks or NBFCs. If you can't do this, there are consultants who can help you. If this is your plan, if this is your expectations from the investors, we will give you 5 to 10 investors. They will suggest you. You can go with them. Finally, executing is a business plan. Planning without execution is a dream, and execution without a plan is a disaster. Don't do that. You have to execute the business plan. So if you come till this point, definitely you cannot fail in your business. You will definitely execute and you will succeed in your business. Okay, so when you are looking at execution, you should take care of your investors, regulators, your own people, operational issues, internal and external, profitability and growth. If you don't have growth in your mind, you can't run the business. If you look about the survival, you will die. If you look at the growth, you will definitely survive. If you look at exponential growth, you will look at nominal growth. So you should be one scale higher than what people say. So all about business plan, I think I gave you most of the things. In addition to this, to just motivate you, or if you're interested, if you write a good business plan of your choice, you have a business idea and you put it as a business plan, okay? And you can send it to B school or engineering college contests. Some of them I just listed, which I was sending my students. Famous was Eureka of IIT Mumbai. I think you can see the table. If some of you are interested, check their website details. There could be some deadlines. I will help you. If you are interested, put your name, your idea, your plan. Okay, I will not get into your thing, completely yours. But if you need some help in on inputs or anything, I'm always there to help you. Okay, I think you can definitely make a try on this. So that's it for the day. Let's go with the Q&A quickly. Yeah, I don't see anyone. Turn your videos on, all of you. So I think some of you already shared. Meghna, Tanuja, Rajshekar, Yatish, they already shared. I want some business idea from you all. Please quickly share. Let us discuss some other point of time. Just an idea, that's it. Not even model, not business plan, just an idea. What business you want to do? Sunil?
Yes, sir. Sir, I want to start a partnership business.
No, I'm asking about business now. That is over. What kind of business organization? That discussion is over. Now we are clearly talking about your own business. Yeah, Srijan.
Sir, I would like to start a restaurant, sir.
Oh, Tanuja, can you hear that? You also said that, right? Meghna, are you writing it?
Yes.
You have to write all these interactions.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes.
Good.
I'm recording Shravya it, sir. Krishna?
Yes, sir. I want to start a food truck, sir.
Oh, food truck.
Yes.
Are you influenced by Pelli Chupulu movie?
No, sir. I have not watched. Yes, sir.
Okay. Please, I do suggest to watch that movie. It's very interesting.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Mallika?
Event planning, sir.
Not audible, say it again.
Event planning, sir.
Oh, event management. I think you already said that, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, no, good.
Sir,
thank you.
Money to...
Yeah, go on. Yes, Sai Priya.
Yes, sir. I want to do online business, sir. Online food business, sir.
Online food. Okay, good. Good. Next.
Yes.
Faster. Please write down Meghna, all. Yeah, Sunil.
Sir, I want to start a resort, sir.
Resort, okay. Holiday resort.
Yes, sir.
So now in resorts also, you know, things are getting changing. They are also getting the specializations. Holiday resort, hospitality resort, yoga resort, spiritual resort, food resort, adventure resorts. There are many. Okay? You can work on them. We'll be asking, discussing all these things in every session. Okay? Yeah, next. I think Rajshekhar told that web designing. Am I right, Rajshekhar?
No, sir. IT company.
You changed, eh?
What, sir?
Last time you told me that it is web designing.
IT company in web designing platform, sir. Web development platform.
No. Company is different. We are talking about small business. Whoever is sharing, it is all about small business. Small business need not be a company.
Okay, sir. Small business means... Okay.
Just doing small business. Like your friends are saying, a resort, a restaurant, online food, food truck. No, all these are feasible for small business. Okay. Monica? So instead of me asking your name, please quickly finish it off. Faster. I think it's better to go by roll number. You always take want like that. Balaji?
Option, sir.
Very good. He is running away from me. Yeah, Naveen?
Option, sir.
Sandeep?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I want to start restaurant and
tell your business. There is no time at all. You need not say good morning, sir. Yes, sir. Quickly tell your business.
Restaurant and poultry farm, sir.
Only one.
Restaurant, sir.
Okay. Padmavati.
Absent, sir.
Anita.
Absent, sir.
Priya?
Sir, I would like to start a boutique, sir.
Boutique, yeah. I think you told me that in the last session. Good. Anu here?
Sir, I want to start agriculture-based machinery, sir.
No, what is that? What is the business we want?
Machinery. And
what machine?
Agriculture-based machinery, sir. crop cutting.
What do you call that as? Can you put it as agro tools?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Agro tools. Anu here. Then Pravallika.
Sir, I want to start a boutique, sir.
Boutique?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Anuja already gave. Bharati? All of you keep your videos on so that it will save time. Okay, go on, Bharati. Not audible.
Interior designing, sir.
Oh, very good. Interior design. Have you designed your home?
My grandmother's home I designed, sir.
Oh, very good. We didn't know that. Share the pics.
Okay.
Okay. Share the pics. We'll be so happy to see your interior design. Thank you. Rajshekhar already told. Malika over. Soumya, Sri Soumya.
Sir, I want to start an online blog for various kinds of jewelries and advertising, sir.
There are many in this country. Online blog, jewelry?
In that online blog, I can post jewelry of different kinds, and depending on the ages of people and the mindsets of people, they can choose what kind of jewelry they want. I just want to start that business, sir.
Okay, but how do you make money out of blogs?
Sir, by posting ads, by advertisements, you can make by.
But it cannot be a business, no. See, if for example, you want to start a YouTube channel or you want to start a Facebook page, you want to start a website and you try to advertise it, that cannot be business. Your idea is good. I'm not discouraging you, okay? But you should have something in your mind. For the time being, I will put it as a jewelry blogging, but try to substitute with something else, okay?
Okay.
I think Meghna, you can write as a jewelry blog, okay? For Soumya.
Okay,
Srijana?
Sir.
Srijana?
Sir, I said restaurant, sir.
Yeah, I think you already done. Yatish?
Yes, sir.
Yatish already told he's doing construction supply. Construction material supply. Yatish, are you there?
Absent, sir.
Hare Krishna?
Absent, sir.
Pravallika?
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I want to start an online grocery delivery business, sir.
Grocery delivery. Okay. Okay, fine. Online grocery delivery. Fine. Good. Chandrika?
Sir?
Chandrika.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, I want to start a boutique, sir.
Boutique? So more
yes,
boutique and food business in my class. Good, good. You have to catch the market, catch the demand. That's very good. That is very wise idea. Good. Janhavi?
Yes, sir. So I want to start a handicraft business, sir.
Handicraft. Oh, good.
Yes.
Very good. Shravya?
Absent, sir.
Absent. Sunil gave? He said resort, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Sunil is over. Sravya Krishna already told food truck. Geeta?
Absent, Geeta is there? Sir.
Absent. Meghna? You gave? You are sticking to this? Same or you want to change?
Yes. Sir, I want to change actually.
Yeah. I got it. That's the reason I was asking you.
Yes, sir. Actually, I want to do this with Anuhya. Because she has, yes, she, they have industry cows, I guess. And so I'm planning to do milk production. Nowadays, like milk in long run, we can stick to that because Tetra Paks and all are chemical processed.
No, that's okay. So you if we and later, I want your business right now.
Yes, milk production, animal husbandry and milk production.
Okay,
milk taking help products. From MSME.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Milk yes, products. Sir. We can put it as.
Yes.
Yeah. Next. Sri Lakshmi.
Sir, absent, sir.
Absent. So then, Bhavani.
Absent, sir.
Oh, Lalita, I'm sorry. She will hit me if I say Bhavani. Fortunately, she is not there. Sai Priya, she already gave. Monica, did you give? Monica has given. Meghna?
So she is absent today.
Okay. So I think that's it for the day. Thank you all for the wonderful participation. This is the session you should have for complete learning. And my kind of faculty would be elated if you're participating this way. So stick to your business idea, stick to your business plan, and we'll roll on in the next sessions. Okay. Thank you all for the participation. See you on Monday, first session. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.